Yo, what up? It's Andy from Veggie Power Gains, and I'm gonna give you 3 tips on how to gain the muscle you want. Tip number 1 is gonna be progressive overload. And what does that mean, Andy? What does progressive overload mean? Progressive overload should be the main indicator of your muscle gain. If you wanna make sure you're gaining the lean mass you want, you have to be progressing on your lifts. Like, there's no way around it. Like, I see so many guys in the gym, they're just like busting their asses doing isolation movements all day and doing like 30, 40 reps on each little bicep exercise, and that's not gonna work, guys. If you guys wanna know, I don't know if you want that, but I want the biggest bang for my buck. And how you get that is by getting stronger on key lifts. Getting stronger on your deadlifts, getting stronger on your squat, getting stronger on the incline presses and weighted pull-ups. That's what's gonna make the biggest changes to your physique. If you wanna see those changes, then you must religiously track all your lifts. Religiously track all of your lifts. What I typically do is I just write it down in the notes to my phone, and that works for me just fine. So guys, remember, track your lifts religiously. And every time you come into the gym, you should be getting stronger. You should be adding 5 more pounds to the bar, or adding 1 more rep to the bar. You should be progressing on your key lifts. That's the main indicator of your muscle growth. That's gonna be 80% of your muscle growth. And the other 20% is just gonna be the isolation movements. Think of isolation movements as the icing on the cake. It shouldn't be your main workout. Your compound movements take that place. Focus on your key lifts. You should be getting stronger at them. It's not about who leads with the biggest pump, or do I have a vein popping out from that pump, or it's about, are you progressing on your key lifts? Like, if you've been benching 175 for the past 3 fucking years, and you wonder why your chest is not growing, you know why, because you haven't been progressing. You've been doing the same weight for 3 years, man, come on. Increase the number of repetitions you do. Typically, I would train in the 4 to 6 range. That's where you get the most dense kind of muscle. What I've noticed is people that have the best physiques that are natural, they're super fucking strong. Like, they're super strong, and they all train in the 4 to 8 rep range is like optimal, I think, for 8 for more volume. But I would focus in the 4 to 6 rep range, getting strong at that, and coming back every week and adding 1 more rep or 5 more pounds to the bar. So that's number 1 and 2. 1 was track all your lifts. 2, make sure you're progressing. Progressing overload, guys. You cannot forget that. You cannot forget that, guys. For tip number 3, what I wanna say is most guys fuck this up when they're lean bulking. They typically eat way more calories than they think they do. There's a guy that messaged me a couple weeks ago. He's like, Andy, I've been following your herbivore fasting guide. I've been doing intermittent fasting every day, but my maintenance is 2,500, but I've been eating 3,500 calories every day for my bulk. And when he told me this, I'm like, bro, no wonder you're getting fat. You're eating 1,000 calories over your maintenance every single day. Why wouldn't you gain fat? You're eating 1,000 fucking calories every day over what your body actually needs. Because your body can only build so much muscle on a daily basis, and the rest is gonna be stored as fat. Most guys don't know this, but your body can only build so much muscle until it just puts on fat. So the sweet spot is 300 to 400 calories over maintenance. That is the sweet spot. And I've done bulks before where I was like up to 180, 190, and it just does not look good. Like, your proportions all out of whack, your abs disappear. It's just not a good look, guys. So the sweet spot is about 200 to 300 calories over your maintenance. That's gonna be your sweet spot to make sure you're gaining lean muscle with a really minimal amount of fat gain. How do you calculate your maintenance, Andy? Like, what do? How do you calculate your maintenance? So how you calculate your maintenance is you take your body weight, you multiply it by 15, and there you go, there's your maintenance. Now you add 300 calories to that, and there's your surplus. You're good. That's your surplus. Tip number four is how much protein you need. Like, you probably think that you need way more protein than you need, than you think you need. So I'm gonna tell you, Andy, how much protein do you need to make sure you're progressing, you're giving your body everything you need? And how I would calculate this is take your body weight and multiply it by 0.8 to 1 grams per pound of body weight, and that should be the optimal amount. So if there's a 170 pound guy, he would multiply by 0.8 to 1 gram, so anywhere from 155 to 170 grams of protein would be optimal if you're on a lean bulk. And yeah, guys, four important takeaways I want to give you is: one, track all your lifts, make sure you're progressing, make sure you're progressing on your key movements. That's two. Three is gonna be make sure you're getting enough protein, 0.8 to 1 gram per pound of body weight. And four, make sure you're eating at a caloric surplus. Make sure you're eating at a caloric surplus and don't overdo it on the calories, guys. You don't need that much calories to grow, stay lean. All right, guys, I hope that gave you everything you need to gain the muscle you want.